Hello YouTube, this is Forza Potenza and welcome to episode 12, I believe, of the Race to Glory. This series is flying by now, and last episode, if you didn't see, we finally progressed out of that blooming DTM thing, which took forever. Now we're into the World Touring Cars, and we start with a trip to the positive part, because we did have a perfect race weekend. And I'm going to turn to difficulty, because it's not fun when it's that easy. Anyway, positive part, here we are. Give it a good old shake. Didn't knock anything over this time, which makes a change. I just realised where my microphone is. Eyes are closed. Right, I've picked one out. And, this is a good one. Plus 5 points. So now we are on 17 points, which is absolutely superb. Couldn't have gone much better than that. I don't know, I'll just close this because I've got to put the thing back in. So now we only need 13 points rather than however many to get the championship done, and then we can move on to another discipline. It's a shame, it's not, we're 1 point off being able to do it without doing the next race. It's so frustrating. Anyway, I'm not too worried about that. Let's get into our first race of this episode. Right, so here we are now. We only need 13 points because of that positive part thing. We got really lucky on that. I did say my next circuit would be either Brands or Porto, but I'm not going to bother with Brands now, I don't think. Porto, we haven't done at all on this series, as far as I know. So we'll do Porto, and then we'll just see what we feel like. The car I was in was Andy Prio's, so yeah, and I'm going to, I don't know if to turn the difficulty or if it was just that one track, but what I am going to do for change, you know, I did say I wanted to do a wet race, because I've only just found this option, so yeah, I'm going to do that, and also complete unrealistic damage. Yeah, I'm going to, I didn't realise those settings were there until last video, so I'm going to play around with them a little bit. Just to make it a bit more interesting. I haven't really driven. I've just realised it's probably not the best place to do my best time to do my first ever race when I'm doing it in the, on a certain circuit, even when I'm doing it in the rain. We'll just have to deal with that. I didn't even check how many laps I was set to then. It would be the same as last time. These races don't tend to be massively, massively long. Quick drink, and we're ready to deal with a circuit I have no idea of the layout. It's a street circuit. This is going to drive me nuts. Telly is probably a bit too loud. Okay, you can't see anything on there because it wouldn't come up on the recording. Anyway, first corner. Circuit I have no clue the way around. I'm just having a bit, I'm trying to guess by the brake markers whether, not by how to do it. I'm guessing that was part of a roundabout, the way it was there. I'm going to go flat out through here, but that's a bit stupid. You need to pull to this side, I think. Alright, second gear corner, apparently I'm taking it in third. Oh my goodness, that is horrendously tight. But now we're coming up to the end of the first sector, and I can tell that we've got a chicane coming up. Oh, this is actually quite scary. I think I'm just doing a better driving on the left hand side. It's going to be a really small chicane, isn't it? Right, and now I'm going to brake this early. I don't know where I should be braking. This is not one of the Formula E chicanes. I'm regretting doing this in the rain now. I really am. It's not particularly difficult to drive. It's just I don't trust myself because it's a track I've never driven on before. Alright, so apparently it's this second gear corner. Oh my goodness, how I didn't hit the wall there. I'm getting super lucky, and why did I say that? Just why, and this is a really hard part to get turned as well. Why the heck did I think that was a good thing to say? On a two lane road, and then I've spun it. And I know we won't be fastest through that bit. Who knows, the Brno track, I think the AI are far too easy on that one. I think they vary on different tracks. It's something I found with Race 07 as well. is like, for example, you race down this, I don't know, like Katiba, and you'd be 15 seconds a lap quicker, and then other tracks you really struggle. Also, changing the damage thing there, because this car is going to get really dinged up, isn't it? Feels a bit slower than I'd like out the corners. I don't know whether that's the rain. Either way, I've messed this up massively now, haven't I? I can just tell. Also, I've probably got the race length a bit too long. I just need to get to the finish line now, because I know this qualifying's gone really badly. One, given the damage of the car. Secondly, it feels... Oh, that's a pit entry. That is horribly done. That is one of the worst pit entries I've ever seen. And this time I have seriously damaged the car. And now we're coming up to the line in a very poor lap time. We were good for that first sector though. I'll say that. It's just the crashes for the rest of it. I think we've got pace to do quite well here. I think it's just that first sector I messed up. Mountain to climb, but like I say, only need 13 points. 6 and a 7 pointer. So basically I just need 2 thirds and the fastest lap, really. When I say it's a 13 points in 2 races, it seems like a lot less. I've just got to not mess up, really. I'm happy to follow other cars. I don't really care. Oh, well, hey, let's see if we can get a good start. We're away now, off the line, and James Thompson has got ahead of us straight away. And now I'm going over the pit exit here. I know it's probably a bit cheeky, but there's nothing coming out of it, so I can probably get away with it. I've already gained one position, which is good for a street circuit. I'm scared to commit to anything because I don't really know all the way around the track at this point. And there's a bit of contact up ahead, I think. Car into the barrier, and I've gone into the back of him. It just seems to be a bit glitchy at times. How am I looking to 10 is what I don't get. Oh goodness, there's a car going slowly. That's 9th place now. I think I've nudged him a bit. I really don't care at this point. Right. Where do we break? He's tapping the wall. I don't want to be too stupid. If I get it turned, I don't care. I'm going to really wreck the car here, because I've got realistic damage on, haven't I? I'm such an idiot. Putting it on for a race like this, I don't know the circuit. Anyway, I'm up the inside. Is it the Russian Bears? Is it the team? Is that the team's name? It's got the two Russian drivers. They're in the older BMWs. Either way, it doesn't really matter, because I'm up into 8. Which, considering everything that's gone wrong, is a decent first lap, I think. Everything that could go wrong has gone wrong in qualifying, so... Oh my goodness. No, that... At least only lost one position. I'm jinxing myself so much. But you do get that bit of a glitch with the wall. Sometimes it just stops you dead. It's like if you just clip the wall side off. Like with the side impact. It's just a bit of a glitch, really. I'm not going to complain. This is... Considering when it was made, such a good game. Well, this is one of the earlier racing games, I think. Given this sort of 2006 or... Yeah, it's 2006 this is set in. Race 07, I think, because... Like, you got the 06 and 07 as standard. I need points now. I'm just... If I don't score in this one, I have no hope in hell of actually getting through. And I now need to think about the chicane, because I'm going to be stupid. And there's a car, I think, retired there. I'm up into 7th, which is good. Car heading down. Yeah, Oliver Tielemans is out the race, so I don't know if that was a car ahead or behind. I should have turned notifications off. I didn't think that would be a problem. But P6, because of the car pitting, I've got damage and apparently need to pit. I'm now into P5. This isn't going too badly. I'm not going to pit with my damage, though. I don't think it's worth it. I've never actually known cars retire on this. I'm actually quite glad I turned up the damage, but then again, I'm sort of not because the amount of cars in the pit. Oh, saved my bacon a bit. There's been a lot of contacts this race, and a lot of it quite severe. We've still got some good speed though. I don't even know how I've gained. I think that's a roundabout anyway. I'm only guessing by the corner layout. But I wouldn't want to race on this circuit in real life, I'll say that. Some real tight corners, and it's not so much the tight corners, it's just that the walls are quite closed in and there's no room for a mistake. You are heading into quite a bad bit of Anko if you get it wrong. And especially with walls on this game, they do spin you out a little bit and stop you dead. There's massive gaps behind. It's going to become a last man standing thing, in which case I am not going to win. Having just hit the car again, I'm enjoying this circuit. I'm glad it's only a 3-lap race. I'm really glad it's only a 3-lap race. And now here we are, I'm ahead of the Russian Bears car now. It's good to see. Up the inside now. That was close. I don't want to be too stupid. I don't want to try and go up the inside and not be able to make it stick. And I'm going up the inside of Lavar. He's going to come in on me, isn't he? I'm fine with that. Oh my goodness, it takes some skill to do this. Oh my goodness, I don't trust myself into any of these corners, into any of these braking zones. It is incredibly, incredibly difficult, and I think I'm regretting turning the rein on a little bit now, because it just makes it so much harder. And I've got to remember about this chicane, you can't try and get away with it. Anyway, we're going to go for third, then just slam the brakes. I forgot there's another corner before it. I'm not looking at the minimap, I'm just concentrating on the road at the moment. I guess I could go for the pit lane if I had to, but I don't really want to. Alright, there we go. And now that's P2, I think. Oh. Now I can see the leader. I'm really doing quite well. What's up with the sound? I don't know if that's the sound of my telly or the sound of my car. Either way, look at that. P1. I've made it too easy for myself with this. I think I will just turn the damage down maybe a smidge. Or maybe I might just not have the rain on. I think it's because of everything, really. The rain's made it a bit too easy. I think the car's going off. I don't know if that's because of the damage, and that's just how they react to realistic damage. I doubt it. I doubt that the game would be that flawed. It probably is to do with it being a street circuit. I've hit the wall a bit there, I think. I've had a hit somewhere. I felt a hit. Otherwise, I don't know if it was me hitting the wall or the car behind hitting me, but either way, it doesn't really matter. I've just got to get this car home safely. I don't mean I can cope with the rain, you know. I think that's what it is. By the way, the rain doesn't really make an effect to my driving. If anyone's wondering, I guess you could say that's a flaw with the game, but then again, it's hard to flaw the game for not having. Though it doesn't have to have good rain. Like, this is quite early on, and the Xbox, and for what it is, this is a superb racing game, and I don't really think Forza, well, I guess you could say Forza got up to the standards, but I don't think the AI did. I say that, the AI just crashed out at every opportunity in this race, but normally the AI in this game are just second to none, so it's hard to really hold anything against the game. There's the game. Anyway. Just take it gentle now. The last thing I want is to mess up at this stage. I'd set up a second, really. Not now, of course, given everything that's happened. But second would have been a good result to start with. And now here we are, we're getting close now. I'm scared of messing it up, though. Because I haven't really got the time to make a mistake with. I can't really afford to make an error. I just need to get through this chicane. This bit is quite difficult. God, I've carried some speed through there. And oh my goodness, how can you even do that? It's so tight. Anyway, we're across the line.
Very well done.
We've won the race. Didn't get the fastest lap though. Fastest lap. Pierre Yves Courtals. There. And we were, I think, some way up it. Yeah, he's 13 seconds a lap faster. Wow. That is absolutely insane. So we get 10 points for that one. I'm happy with that though. We only need 3 points into the next race. Let's get into it. Right, so we only need 3 points now to get through, well, to complete the touring car category of this. It's taking a bit longer than I would have liked because of the category B, but that's not a problem. We're racing around Valencia, same car as normal, we're driving Prios. I'm going to make this a 5 lap race because I know this circuit's a little bit shorter. I haven't sort of had a test bit, I know it's a bit cheeky, but it's purely by accident. It was genuinely a case of, I did sort of do a lap, then realised I took the race to 3 laps, not 5. So I wanted to sort that out, because I thought 5 lap, I like to have my race about 10 minutes on this. Like 8 to 10 minutes, if it goes a bit over, I don't really mind too much. But like it's open that, I like to do like a 25 minute to half an hour video, so that normally is about a 10 minute race. Anyway, enough about that. Stuff you didn't really need to know, but stuff you now know, you might see it either way. Anyway, into qualifying we go. This is something that does matter, as far as I'm concerned. And we're getting ready now. We cross the line. First corner. Just don't do anything stupid, really. That's the only advice I've got. I don't want to give advice now. I'm not exactly a hot lap expert, like, I don't know, Martin Brundle or, yeah, not like the F1 team, I'm not that good at it. Anyway, second corner, and ooh, we were a little bit wide, I wasn't expecting that, just, ooh. But I quite like this corner, it just seems to have a flow to it, this track, and, oh, don't go too quick. I've made a little bit of an error. Minor errors. I'm trying to be cautious, but I'm. Because I think this is sort of take two of doing the qualifying run because of the problems with the lap. Amount of laps. I think it's. I'm being a bit more idiotic, which can be after you sort of know it a little bit. It's just. I'm being a bit too brave. Now I think that's what's happening. Now this corner's quite tricky, there we go. But these ones coming up now, like, you don't really get much straight line braking, you don't really get much of a straight to brake on. So it's like you have to sort of brake while turning, and that's not very good. It's hard to get the apex for both corners there. You're turning pretty much the whole time, you don't really get a chance to come off. I don't like this bump into here, like, you're going too quick, that will cause massive issues, but then again, you shouldn't be going that quick anyway. Anyway, now we're coming right up to the final corner. I hate this final corner though, because that's the bit where you're meant to be braking, and you just need to slow down a bit beforehand. You don't really get enough of a straight to get on the brakes, really. But that is a decent lap time, I think. I don't expect it to be pole position, but let's see. Oh, it is. That was quite quick as well. Yeah, about a tenth quicker on the first sector, quite a bit quicker in the second sector, and yeah, the third as well. I should have turned the difficulty down, shouldn't I? The reason I didn't is I just thought it was one circuit. Now, and I'd get together and thought of hard, like, I like medium difficulty, the thought of hard, I just think, I'm never going to do that. Hopefully they won't all run each other into the, pits like they did in the last race. That's all I can say now. That was fun though. I can't believe that actually happened. To race day we go, and starting from pole, this should be pretty easy now, I reckon. It is lights out. Away we go. And here in Valencia now, and look at this, Rob Huff has got us off the start. Oh, he's cut me up now, that is a bit cheeky, the way he's sort of closing on me. Left it as fine as he could, really. Couldn't have left me any, much less room without hitting me. I don't think he's coming across me. Anyway, second corner. Having regained that lead. It's let's see what we can do. Right, we're good through here. Oh, the bump's getting me a bit here. Like, you don't even notice it normally, but now I'm sort of feeling the bumps a little bit on the car. And, ooh, that is a bit scrappy, but it will do. Yeah, so this could be another one of those races, couldn't it? Oh, goodness. I've had too many of them in this series now. It gets a little bit boring after a little bit. Anyway, we're good through here. Right, now, slam on the brakes. Good turning. Oh, bit wide. Yeah, and I can just turn the mini-map now. We've got a massive, massive gap. Not even at the end of the first sector. And I think I've locked up at some point in that. 2.7 second lead now. Oh my goodness. This is getting a bit too easy for my liking, I think. Oh, I am regretting not turning up the difficulty now. I would like a bit more of a challenge. Now, turn. I'm off. I'm just going to keep going, floor it, and we're back in the way. Now let's see what the gap is after the first lap. 3 seconds. I've still gained despite going into the gravel. It is far too easy. But I thought I was going massively off then. It was one of those moments I just thought I wasn't going to get the car slowed down. And now the brakes are phenomenal on this. They're phenomenal. Did they even say that right? I don't know. Yeah, either way. Oh my goodness. I think most of the fun of this is just me trying to say words. And oh, we're off. We are into the gravel. That's not gone particularly well. And all that gap that we'd built up has only gone down by half a second, apparently. Oh. A bit surprised by that. Thought I would have gained a little bit more. Either way, this is good through here now and onto this straight. I do quite like this track. Like some games, like when you're just driving around, because that's what it feels like. It just feels like hot lapping at times. Some games, it can get a bit boring when it starts to feel like hot lapping because you're that far ahead. But with a good track, you don't have that. I mean, that's why I don't really play much of the F1 games, like beyond 3-lap races, because like, when you get to like 25%, 50%, eventually the cars around you will sort of disperse, and if you're not fighting someone, it's not that fun really. You're just hot lapping, really. And if you're not really gaining on anyone, not really losing to anyone, it's not really that fun. Sometimes I'd just rather go be that bit further back, not be contesting for like the win or something. Well, like, not be contesting for whatever position I'm contesting on, just to get some good battles. Anyway, end of lap 2, and we're going to have a massive lead despite having quite a scrappy run of it, aren't we? Yep, 4.1. And now, that was probably far too late to what should be working. Should have turned the difficulty up, really. Oh, this is the problem I have with some games. Like, they just get a bit tedious when you do too well. And that's the problem I'm having. It sounds like a weird thing to moan about. But no, it's at the end of the day, I only do this to have fun. It's not been fun when you just get massive leads like this all the time. And yeah, I do need to turn it. Next time I'm on this, note to self, I need to turn up the difficulty because this is just driving. Barely racing at this point. The only time I've seen another car is just Rob Huff got alongside me into the first corner. And then just dealt with him by the second, so. Yeah, just keep going. This is it. Oh. Get it turned. Don't go too wide. Yeah, we're a bit wide then. And we've got a gap of 7.5 seconds. No. Oh my goodness. I was expecting to be able to take a bit more speed now. I just thought I'd try it. Because you never know. keep it to his right hand side just to get the car straightened up for the braking zone and get it turned in. Spectacular. And 2 laps remaining. As of now. And that's my quickest lap so far, because I was being a bit brave. I was also being a bit stupid, and I've lost almost 2 seconds, but I don't really care about being stupid at this point, because I just want to get this race over with. Anyway, I'll stop ranting about my poor decisions in choosing the AI difficulty level. It sounds a weird thing to say, I know. Things you come up with when you're obsessive compulsive sado. Playing race pro on YouTube, yeah. It's not an exciting life, but it's fun. I'm just talking nonsense now. That's what happens. That's the worry with this. You know, it's getting to the point where I'm only doing this because I want to progress with this series. And I start talking complete and utter nonsense. When I originally wanted to do career mode stuff a few years ago on the F1 games, I did try and do one called Battle at the Back. I did sort of start doing it, and I then sort of got a bit bored because it's just half an hour of just me driving and talking and that stuff. It stopped being fun. So it's really weird, like. And yeah, I just wanted to use it like a time to talk about things, but then again, I was never going to do enough videos to make it a regular thing. I ended up using that to footage from one of the second episode outtakes as background footage for another video. It's interesting, the funny thing is all these videos are deleted. Much like the crash compilations, and I realised I remember doing one, and I remember like doing some quite realistic crashes, and then I deleted it because I just deleted everything that used to be on my old YouTube channel, like from the hard drive everywhere. So there's no recollection of those files except in my mind. And I'm massively wired now, but I don't really care. I'm just gonna get back onto the track, and there we go. Nice turning. Yeah, this has been far too easy. I'm actually not enjoying this. I'm just. Turns. Feels like I've done more than 4 laps. I'm literally just driving at this point, making silly mistakes and not being penalised for them. 8 second gap. That's despite literally spending a straight just going through the gravel. Anyway, on to this technical bit. Something that might be slightly challenging. Hooray. There we go, good turn. And we're good through here. Let's not mess this up now massively. And my split time is exactly equal with everything else I've done. And then the thing is, I know I could go a lot faster than this. I know I could probably, if I was going for lap times or I had it on hard difficulty, I would be trying to go second, maybe 2 seconds faster, but I just don't need to. I'm letting myself make stupid mistakes because it really doesn't make a difference whether I win the race or not. Anyway, final corner, massive mistake once more. I don't really care at this point, I know I'm going to win the race. Let's just get the car to the line, get this race done with, and yeah.
Race is finished, you won the race, very well done.
Another fantastic win. Anyway, so that means that we finished on. That's it, let me tally this up, because I've got 12 points from that. I'm not going to go into the positive part for the next one, because, well, I could if I wanted to. Actually, no, I might do, because it's rallying. But yeah, so we finished on 12, 24, 24. We finished on 39 points, which is, bar like having the positive part for everything, that is the maximum you can get. It's actually ridiculous. So yeah, that's the way the touring cars finish. I may go on and do sort of a montage video like I did last time I completed one. But anyway, if that doesn't happen, my next video will probably be going on to the rallying. Because I'm leaving the Formula stuff for last, because I want to end with a big finale on the Formula 1. Anyway, Thank you for watching this video. This has been Forza Potenza, and I shall see you next time. Bye!